jambo ambalo haliwezi likalinganishwa. You cannot match with anything being in the presence of God. Kwa sababu in the presence of God is God's joy. Kuna furaha tele katika mambo. Ni furaha kwa sababu vyote vinashughulikiwa na Mungu wa Mungu. Bwana asifiwe sana. Katika kitabu cha Mhubiri Biblia inasema Mhubiri 12:13. Biblia sema ya kwamba fear God and keep his commandments. For that is all for human being. Mche Mungu na uweke torati yake. Kwa sababu hiyo ndio yote ambayo mfalme Solomon. Ni mtu ambaye alikuwa amebarikiwa sana na Mungu katika kila upeo wa maisha. Lakini anasema baada ya kuona yote mazuri ambayo Mungu anatenda, baada ya yote mcheni Mungu. And keep his commandments, that is all a human being is made for. So it's wonderful to be in the presence of God and just give him thanks, give him praise. You can greet somebody on your left and on your right, even as we go into the session of praising and worshiping. Praising God with songs of dancing, celebrating Jesus.
Changing move of God. EL-ROI TV, your channel of choice.
Oh, to be lifted up.
Hakuna sila, you don't say.
Yeah.
temple of glory of all nations, Kitengela, a place where Jesus is at the center of it all. Bwana Yesu ndio mambo yote katika ukumbi huu. And to our viewers who are viewing us from wherever you are, we say thank you for joining us, and we welcome you once more, even as you proceed with the service. And I want to say to you that distance is not a barrier. The word of God is spirit and life, but spirit knows no barrier. Spirit knows no limitation. From wherever you are, God will still reach out to you. Stay put and keep on with us, even as we go to another level. So right now, I want to take this opportunity to tell all of us that we want to go to serve God with our substances. Praise the Lord. Is it not wonderful that God has blessed us? Who of us really prayed hard to be alive today and God gave it? It is not even by prayer, it is by His grace. Praise the Lord. By the grace of God we are saved, but through faith and through one Jesus Christ. And that is the reason why we are. And that's why we want to celebrate Him and thank Him, worshiping Him with our voices and also with what He has blessed us with. It could be whatever He is giving. It could be kind, it could be cash. Sasa tutakuwa na mbele za Mungu na sadaka zetu na hata fungu la Mungu. If you have your time and you want to check before the Lord today, please write your name in an envelope that you have been given out to believe so, and put your time inside there. And also for all those of us who are giving our offering, please put in that envelope, but don't write anything on the envelope when you're giving your offering. Praise the Lord. And even to those of us who are online, you can also give as the Lord prompts you. Unaweza kutoa through the account that is just right in your screen. You can see the account. So you can just go through that and give your offerings and even your tithes to the Lord. Praise the name of Jesus Christ. Are we ready to give to the Lord? Are we ready to give to the Lord? An offering is something very important. I don't know if we know about that. Your offering is not just something you think about rushing out of your pockets and dip it into the offering basket. No. An offering is very precious before the Lord. It gave time in memorial with the children of Israel, even with Abraham. And God treated offerings with a lot of seriousness. Sadaka zetu ni muhimu sana mbele za Mungu. Sasa uishughulikie katika njia ambayo inafaa. Shughulikia sadaka yako katika njia ambayo inastahili Mungu ambayo unampatia. Sio kuikunja kunja. That is a sacrifice you're giving before God. You remember they were told to bring animals without blemish. Wale ambao hawana hata madoa. Why was God so particular about that? So they said tu mlete kondoo na mlete mbuzi. Lakini alikuwa very particular akasema kwamba mlete wale ambao sio walemavu. Mlete wale ambao hawana madoa doa. God is so serious when it comes to issues around offerings that are given to His altar. So when you give your offering, treat it with a lot of respect. Usikunjekunje, just, you know, physically may see you are giving to this place here, but in the spirit you are giving it right before Jesus Christ. So treat your offering with a lot of honor as you honor God. Ukiwa unamheshimu Mungu na sadaka yako. Iweke katika hiyo bahasha. Kisha ufungulie hapo na tupate dakika mbili kama vile tumefanyaga ya kwamba uweze kuendelea hiyo sadaka. Speak over that offering, that which you want God to listen to. Because it's an offering you're giving to God. Speak over it. Even your tithes, if you have your tithe, will you speak of it in the name of Jesus Christ? We are people of promise. We are people of covenant. We have a covenant with God even in our offerings. So speak something about it. Thank you, Jesus. Our loving Father, we thank you for this great opportunity. This one you have granted to us, Lord, to worship you with the word you have given unto us. You have opened a door one more time, Lord, that we may come to your altar with our offerings, with the sacrifices that we have brought before you. We pray, Lord, that you accept them, Lord. And even as we have prayed over them, Lord, may you hear our voices, God.